Hey, what up, y'all? Least85 here, and welcome back to another Borderlands the pre-sequel video. I just wanted to make this video to let you know about some information on updates that are coming out on November the 11th, alongside with the Handsome Jack DLC. And also, Jeff, the community manager for Gearbox, has made a post in the forums recently about Endgame and the farmability for the pre-sequel. I know a lot of you guys already know that a lot of the bosses are unable to respawn, so they aren't unable to be reformed for different legendaries. There's actually quite a few bosses in the game that we can't even go back and farm unless you're dashboarding or Alt-F4 farming to get these legendaries. And it's kind of upsetting once you get to the end of the game. You want to complete your backpack with all your loot and get all the legendaries, and you're unable to because these bosses do not spawn like they did in Borderlands 2. So, yeah, I'll put an image on the screen, though, of the thread post that he posted. And basically it's saying that the team is aware of the community's desire to increase the farmability for the bosses and for the different legendaries in the game. They're looking at some approaches to address this concern. Nothing is set in stone, as you see it says, but they're definitely aware of it. So I think that's cool that they're acknowledging it. They're noticing that we're speaking out about how we feel about Endgame and Borderlands the pre-sequel. It's not the same how it is in Borderlands 2, being able to reform these bosses. Like I said, you know, everybody wants to farm these bosses to complete their backpack or to get the legendaries that they want, and we are just unable to because the bosses just don't respawn. But it's cool that they're speaking out and they're at least acknowledging this, and hopefully they will fix it in the near future here so we can actually farm these bosses permanently rather than dashboarding or Alt-F4 farming. And because that's never fun, to sit there and wait to reboot the game and and possibly corrupt your game save at the same time. So but now on to the actual updates that are coming out on November 11th. Unfortunately, the farmability being fixed is not on here like I was hoping it was going to be. But some of the things that are here, there are three different ones, and I'll put the links down below if you want to look at them yourself. There's a PC one, an Xbox 360 one, and a PlayStation 3. They're more or less the same with just minor differences. This is the PC one that I'm going to read off here. It says that it adds support for upcoming downloadable content, which is going to be the Handsome Jack content. The Boganella gun, I believe I'm saying that right. The gun that would talk. Sometimes it would talk over itself and it would overlap. They fixed it to where it doesn't overlap anymore. They've also fixed the missions that were glitched and you were unable to complete, which is great. The Let's Build a Robot, Science and Violence, Home Sweet Home, and Lost Legion Invasion. I never actually had any of these issues, but I know a lot of people did, and there were some fixes out there for it, but now they're actually going to fix it in-game. So those of you that happen to be stuck on one of these missions on the 11th, they're going to put a patch out for you guys. Also, something about Jack, where he would stop moving in front of a vending machine during the Lost Legion invasion, that's going to be fixed as well. The I Can Do This All Day challenge will now properly update. Players will no longer spawn in areas which prevent them from advancing the story. Now this, I have actually noticed this a couple times. If you save and quit too fast, you will respawn in the beginning of the game. At the very beginning of the game, where you meet Claptrap and you're about to meet Jack. Except there's nothing there. There's nowhere to go. You would have to save and quit again. And I don't know what caused that, but I noticed that if you do save and quit too fast, if you save, quit, and then start the game right back up, it would spawn you there every once in a while. So they're going to fix that as well. A couple other, minor things like Russian and Japanese players are able to connect to each other. Something about the Lost Legion fighter crew are now able to spawn. They weren't able to spawn every time. And that's something to do with the mission not being able to be completed as well. So yeah, a few bug fixes here. It's good to see that they're actually working on some of these things. And I would say that a lot of the major ones, like the mission things, those are pretty important. Not being able to complete the game is pretty damn important. So it's good that they're fixing it, and they're just going to be putting it out when the DLC comes out. It's kind of sucks that they did not fix the farmability. That's something I'm really, really hoping for. Because you guys know me, that I love killing the bosses over and over. I love farming the legendaries. That's kind of like what I like to do. But maybe in the future, hopefully we'll get that. And I'm sure there's a lot of other bugs that people have found that will be addressed eventually when they find them out. So we'll have to wait and see. If you guys want and there's something that's not on this list that's getting fixed and you've noticed a bug in the game, put it in the comments. Let us know, and hopefully maybe they'll see it. Probably not, but I'd still like to see it. And yeah, hope this helped you out. Links in the description below if you guys want to look at it for yourself. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you.